Welcome to Cumberland Matters, the program where we bring what's happening in Cumberland County to you. I'm John Soles, and in this episode, Cumberland County Sheriff's deputies talk about the School Resource Officer Program and how law enforcement and mentoring help school children learn in a safe environment.
The School Resource Officers Program, Cumberland County Sheriff's Office, we maintain the security of the schools to make sure it's a good, safe working environment for the staff, the faculty, and also a good learning environment for the students. I've been doing it about 15 years and works out fairly well. The task and responsibility of a school resource officer, we ensure the safety of the school to make sure it's a good working environment, good learning environment for the faculty, staff, students as well. We enact on the laws of North Carolina. We enforce those laws as well. Not only that, but I mean, we're there as mentors, teachers, different things. We're not there just to law the kids. We're also there just if the kids need someone to talk to about law, just about life in general. In Cumberland County, we have 52 elementary schools where we have 10 elementary school deputies that are assigned to 52. We have 17 high schools. In all 17 high schools, we have a deputy. And we have 18 middle schools. And in 18 middle schools, we have a deputy all times. And we have 4 supervisors. When I first got here, we had maybe 10 high schools. Since then, we've added on our early college, Fayetteville State Early College. We've added on Ramsey Street Alternative, Algie B. Wilkins, and 3 or 4 others. Reed Ross Classical used to be middle. Now it's a middle and high, and it's a classical school. So as far as school-wise, a lot of schools have been added in. Deputy-wise, when I first got here, we might have been 20 of us. Now it's almost 50 SROs. We've grown in elementary schools. Usually what we had when we had a high school or a middle school deputy, whoever was the closest to those elementary schools, that's who's handled those elementary schools. Well, since then we have grown and we've added 10 elementary school deputies, which handle maybe 7 in the zone. They're split into zones. And we have the deputies, they go out and they handle those. And it helps a lot better, because you have a better chance of to engage with the kids, to get to know the kids, and they really like that. Start with them at a young age, and they really like that. It helps with the respect factor. It really does, and you get to meet the parents, teachers, and it really works out a lot.
A school resource officer has many roles and responsibilities. One of the biggest thing we do is work with the kids. Obviously, we're there for crime prevention and to handle any criminal activities that may occur in the school. But one of the biggest things we try to do is build relationships with these kids so that if something does happen or if they do need help, if they have any problems, they know that we have an open door policy and they can come and speak with us. We are a big liaison between the sheriff's office and the school board system. Anything that happens with the schools, obviously the sheriff is responsible for and handles, but the school board also needs to know about what goes on. So the biggest thing we do is just we're there for them and handle any criminal activities and anything that happens on a daily basis. The GREAT program, which stands for Gang Resistance Education and Training, is going on its 30th year, and what it is, it's a national and international program that is designed to prevent youth violence and gangs as well. Its basis is it serves as an immunization against delinquency and crimes, gangs, all of those types of things. We teach it a 6-week program in the 4th grade, and then there's a 13-week program in the 6th grade. And what these programs are designed to do is to help kids with anything from learning how to control their anger to brushing up on their communication skills, learning to stay away from gangs, learning what violence is in general, learning the types of things they can get in trouble for in schools, and pretty much just trying to be there for them, a mentor for them that they can look up to and say, hey, you know, these officers are just like real people. They're just like our parents, and they're here for us. And that's one of the big things the GREAT program tries to instill. We often go in classrooms to talk to kids, whether it's about drug use, some of the current things with cell phones, those types of crimes. Any crime that we can think of, we try to go in these classrooms and talk to them. We are required by our supervisors to go in and speak with these kids, give them a heads up on what is happening out there so that they understand that they can be held accountable if they choose to break some of these laws. Our job, our biggest thing that we want to portray to these kids is that we are there for them. Yes, we wear a uniform, but we want them to be able to come up and talk to us. Whether they're in trouble or whether they hear something that's going on, we want them to be able to trust us, and that's the biggest thing in these schools is building a relationship of trust with these kids. That's our main goal, so that if something happens, they will come up to us. Well, there's obviously a lot of school resource officers in Cumberland County. We are at the schools all the time. Anyone can come up to us and ask us about what we do, but they can also speak with the sheriff and find out more about the school resource program and what our responsibilities and duties are.